Fightheights.com, association with Fight Hype. Here with Andreas.
Pronounce your last name for us.
Kazurakis.
Yeah.
I can't get it.
That's a hard one. That's a hard one.
So any fight news coming up? Any fight dates coming up?
I think I have something early December.
In December?
Yeah.
Okay.
Early December.
So how long you've been with Ronnie Shields? How long now? Like,
I think it has to be like around 5 months now.
How you feel? Like, you feel like you developed? Like, you think you're gonna put on a different show? Are you excited to put on, like, some new things you learned? Because I remember you told us that you was a brawler, but Ronnie's been showing you how to box a little bit more. So
I mean, I'm the kind of guy that will put in the work. So when I get in the ring, whatever the other guy brings to the table, I will have more.
Yeah.
I will not say like these things that everybody says, like I will be more strong or more fast or anything like that, but 100% I will be ready and I will be more prepared than the other guy. So even if he has something to bring up to the table, if he's good or anything like that, during the later rounds on the deep waters, I will be there.
What do you think Ronnie has brought more out of you that you didn't have maybe before you started training with Ronnie?
I think as a fighter, I mean, I always was applying pressure and stuff like that and was going for the close-up game and all that kind of stuff. But Ronnie took advantage of my talent outside of that, like moving a little bit around, moving my head more, applying my counters in the process of moving around the ring and following the guy. And I think he added some slickness in the whole process, and that's what we're working on.
Okay, is that exciting for you? Is it just learning new stuff?
Yes, 100%. Because I knew that the other things I already could do. I mean, of course, there's room for improvement on everything, but I felt like I would always be 100% ready in the fight to apply pressure 3 minutes and fight for 3 minutes. But the fact that I know with Ronnie will develop in my boxing 100% all these years that we'll be together, I mean, it's amazing.
With learning some of these new tools, how easy or how hard was it to adjust to learning new things that you...
It wasn't hard.
So that means it's kind of natural. It just, you just needed that right guy to bring it out.
Yeah, exactly. That's how I felt. I mean, that's what Ronnie says. It wasn't hard. I mean, the first time that we start working on some stuff, immediately, I felt like I already had it. That's how I felt.
Is that one of the reasons why you chose Ronnie as a trainer for you?
I mean, I knew Ronnie, and when I was about to come back, because I was 3 years in LA, then I went back home for a little bit, and when I was about to come back, you know, I started looking for some coaches because my guys had already proposed me like some of the best coaches around here, and I'm like, I want Ronnie Shields. And, you know, they thought about the logistics of getting me an apartment and all the kind of stuff here. It would be a little harder. So we preferred the coach that would have me in camp. That's why I went to Big Bear. Mm-hmm. But after I left Big Bear, I'm like, guys, I want Ronnie Shields. Yeah. So they're
you
like,
just knew it. Like,
yeah,
knew
yeah,
it.
I want it because it wasn't only this, like, I was in Jamal that he has now and all the fighters that he's developing. And of course, all the fighters that he had in the past. And he was working with George Benton back in the day and all that kind of stuff, and it's so important to me. And I was looking at some interviews that he was doing, and as a person, I really liked him, and I felt like we could click together very nice as a team. So now I'm like, I want Ronnie Shields.
So what do you feel like makes it work? Like, makes y'all's partnership work? What do you?
I mean, I felt from the beginning, I felt that he's the kind of guy that he's old school. And he's very disciplined in the gym. He wants you to work hard, do the things that he tells you, no question, all that kind of stuff. And I'm exactly that.
I see that it's very structured.
Yeah.
And you like that. Like, it's not all over the place.
Yes, I love it. I want to know what I'll have the entire week as a program. I want to know how the camp will go throughout my fight until I get to my fight. And Ron is exactly like that. I will know what I have to do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, throughout the entire week. What program we have, you come in here, you laugh around probably a little bit before the training. Once you start training, that's it. There's no laugh around, no talk around, you do your thing and you leave.
Cool. So you say December, right?
Yeah, December.
It's not final yet?
Not final yet.
But
let's don't jinx that because I already have some cancellations on the fights. Yeah, but I think December will be...
What do you think the issue with guys wanting to fight you? Because you maybe not that known to them or what?
So I don't really think that there is an issue about guys don't want to fight me because I think you can always find someone to fight you.
Yeah.
I think we're in a position right now that we're talking with some promoters to sign with, and we are waiting for them to get something done. So, yeah, but that's about it. I mean, I don't want to say like a lot of stuff before anything happens.
Yeah.
So we just wait.
Okay. And you're fighting at 160, right?
160, but until now, but I'm going down to 54.
154?
Yeah, okay, you did say that last time.
Yeah, I'm going down to 54.
So would this fight be at 160?
154.
Possibly?
154.
Oh, 154, okay. Yeah.
What are you looking to accomplish at 154? Because that's a pretty stacked division too. You got Tony Harrison, of course. You got Charlo.
I love the division. I mean, I really like it. So my thought process was, I'm here because I know what I'm capable to do. Otherwise, I would be back in Greece doing other stuff. So I'm not like sacrificing all that, my family time and my girlfriend and my whole life basically back in Greece to come here and just play around. I know that I'm capable to do. That's why I came here. So being 160. I knew that I could reach the top, but I'm like, because I was getting to 160 so easy, like I want to try 154 because there's two divisions now. You know, if I'm 160, I can go at 168 later on in my career, but being 154, 160 and 168, I mean, you know, you have more space to develop and more divisions to conquer.
So 154 wouldn't be too much for you to come down to? You think you still have the power?
No, yeah, it's easy. My last fight, I weighed in 156 and a half. I had breakfast the day of the weigh-ins. I mean, I didn't have any problem getting the weight. So 154 will be it.
So what you walk around weighing right about now, like while you're training?
Now I'm around 70, but I'll go down. Now that we know that probably in December I'll fight, I'll go down to around 65. So I don't want to be more than 10 pounds away from my division.
Okay, so hopefully we'll get you back in the ring in December.
Yes, sir.
So you can showcase your new skills. Yep. Your Ronnie Shields, man. Yep. We look forward to seeing you.
Yeah, it's going to be nice. Thank you, guys.
Appreciate you.
Oh, if you enjoyed the video, feel free to hit the like, subscribe, and share. As always, if you want to support us to the next level, head over to the patreon.com/theboxingvoice. We have tons of exclusive from Border Wars, Entitled, betting shows, the list goes on and on and on. But in addition to that, if you guys have questions for fighters, trainers, and promoters, this is where you can submit them. We will run out, get these questions answered, and put it back on the show just for you guys. Appreciate it. Peace.